All right, so what is good, everybody on YouTube? This is, of course, your boy B, Bold RC, coming to you guys again with yet another video. And it is Sunday, and your boy has not been to any local malls because I was traveling worldwide for about 2.5 to 3 weeks now. I want to definitely hit up Ross. I need to hit up the mall and maybe a thrift here and there, maybe a thrift or two. And I need to make sure that next week, maybe coming up, I do a new thrifting video. I definitely need to do another sneaker hunting video on like Ross and Marshalls. I had a couple of you guys asking about that. So shouts out to the thrift gang worldwide. And also, of course, shouts out to the notification gang, those who finesse the bell. Y'all already know how I do. Your names are scrolling right now. If you see yourself, a comment down below. This is the finesse gang right here. Listen, if you haven't finessed the bell, go ahead and click the bell. And if you haven't subscribed, if this is your first video, what's good, and go ahead and subscribe, because you already know the heat is coming. I'm dropping heat in your timeline 5 days out of the week sometimes. But you guys know what dropped yesterday, the Flyknit Air Jordan 1. And I really want to see it in person. Hopefully it's still in stores. I know it's sold out on most places online, and it's sold out on the Nike sneakers app. But the Nike sneakers app, some shit that sells out up there is like, I know I can still find it in store. And my homie actually went up to the mall yesterday. He checked out the Air Jordan 1s, and he actually ended up passing on them. They had both of sizes that he wanted, either his true size or his half size down. And he was telling me he really didn't like the way a toe box looked. And I feel like there's a lot of people that are on the fence about this release. So I really want to get a pair and do a review for you guys, because I know they're not just going to drop the Breads. They're going to bring the Royals. And I don't know what other colorways, maybe the Chicago and the knit joints, the granny knits. So if I can today, I want to walk away with a pair of those. And if I can get a thrift blessing, or if we can find something somehow in Ross, because I haven't been here for 2 weeks, so hopefully some of the stock has refreshed, we can do that. So listen, y'all know what the hit list is. It's so great to be back home, and I need to do that giveaway too, the local giveaway thing. Some of y'all know what I'm talking about, some of y'all will soon. But anyways, let's go ahead, let's get it. Hey, 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 spent 50K on the roadie. She brought that shit and my bitch broke it. She saying that she need notice, but her pussy wet like the ocean. Master Bruce, yeah, I'm the coldest. Master Bruce, yeah, I'm the coldest. Modular and Eric Owen, I'm fucking up front and she know it. Modular, bad. My trophy still cold like Steve Austin. Don't cut for no bitch, we just toss them. Nigga, this they live in Harlem. Yeah, right. Yeah. There in your hood, right in your local bodega. Frankie gon' ball like Omega. This ain't no game like no Sega. Even though that beef old, I don't care. I will not fuck with the Raiders. Second deal locked with Adidas. Fergie done got him a sneaker. Make your bitch sing like Aretha. Fresh is like cotton, I kill Alright y'all, so we have made it to the first spot, which is Ross. And like I said, in the coming weeks, maybe this week, next week, I will do a new sneaker shopping vlog. Of course, y'all can see the Ross name up there. Now, I just seen a dude walk in with a bronze tee on, a bronze 56K tee on, so I may need to look extra quick. So let's see if we can find anything in here. Hopefully we come upon something. Yeah, make me with a Leo. Rest in peace until I see you.
Yo, 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 popping these pills on my coat. I'm at the roof, move like I'm Batman. Yo, damn, what? Marjola Madman.
These niggas, they still on my flow. Talking my home, boy, I'm still in your home. Taking your hoe to the pad, she getting lit. She tryna suck on the dick. Yo, yo, yo. She wanna suck in the dick. She wanna suck like a tit. Hey, yo,
all right, y'all, so we just came out of Ross. As you guys can see back there, y'all know the name. And I didn't find anything. The best thing that they had were the Lunar Charges. And then they had a couple of Prime Knit Adidas that I had never seen in the store before. And a lot of the stuff was actually gone. All those Air Jordan cleats I usually see are gone. And I feel like they just reallocated a lot of the stock out of this Ross into another one. So no Ross blessings this time. It wasn't a bad trip, though. At least I saw a couple new things. And those Teleriers, listen, if you are size 14, 15. They're $40 in there. Don't play yourself. The Tulare is a hot shoe. I know it's not the most hype shoe. It's a hot shoe. It's a comfortable shoe. Just hit it with some rejuvenator, clean it up, keep it moving. $40. If they had my size of $40, I'd probably buy another pair. Anyways, man, next stop, we need to get to the mall. Last stop is gonna be a thrift, and then we come back. Hopefully, we only have to go to one mall. There's a couple malls that got the shoe, but hopefully they have my size in this first one, so your boy don't have to do too much driving. But all that aside, let's get it. What? Sound like a tick. Suck on this shit. Get on the click. Get on the click. Get on your knee. Pray for the dick. Pray for the shit. Pray for my click. Pray for my knee. All right, y'all. So we have made it to the mall, and I'm hoping we can just go ahead and luck up. Your boy, he's running Commonwealth, and you're running Foot Action, Foot Locker. Champs, I just haven't been to my home mall, my main mall, in a while. Your boy's been traveling, so let's go ahead, head in here, and see if I can get lucky or if I need to go to another one. We'll see.
A few moments later.
All right, y'all, so we're in our first spot. We are in Foot Action right now, and I do see them. Okay, they do have them. So this one right here is a size 8, but they always have their smallest sizes out, not their biggest sizes. So I might be able to grab a pair in my first spot, in my first store that I come in. But I also wanted to check out, because I knew they had all the new swingman jerseys and stuff from Mitchell & Ness. I need that Bucks jersey ASAP. Other than that, I mean, these came out. I didn't even know these came out, bro, but I'm sleeping super, super heavy on this pair. Not a big fan. And with all the other colorways that dropped, I'm not really surprised to see these guys right here. So I got a couple questions about these two. I didn't have a chance to make a Will You Cop. I think these are called the Island Green, or basically they remind me of Electric Blues, just with a silver swoosh. Now, I had the Electric Blues with the black swoosh, the Pros, which is probably one of my favorite pair of foam posits, but I ended up selling those a long time ago for like $300, and I had already worn them like 3 or 4 times. Y'all know I like the foams, but for me, sizing is a problem because they run kind of tight, so I'm probably just gonna pass on that one. I'm still waiting to get the eggplants anyway, so there's no need to get those guys right there. So I mentioned these two guys earlier, but they got these new swingman jerseys, and this bug joint right here, that joint is fire. They even got the shorts to match them too. I know they have a Denver Nuggets colorway too, but I don't see those down here. But they do have a couple other ones, just like the Orlando Magic joints. I still need to get these shorts for sure. I just haven't picked them up yet. If I don't get any shoes today, I might have to come back for the Ray Allen Bucks joint. I might have to do it. Okay, update. We just came out of Foot Action and we got some bad news. I thought that Jim having one shoe on the rack meant that some stuff was sitting, but apparently everything sold out. That was their last shoe that was left with a size 8. So now I'm about to head to Foot Locker and see if they have any. I don't think Champs got them at all. And DTLR might have got them, so I can check. But as of right now, it's looking pretty slim. I might have to call up another mall and see if they have them, or just go on a launch locator and call up a few malls if I want to get them today, but we'll see. All right, y'all, so the next store we're checking out right now is Foot Locker, and it's looking pretty slim, bro. I'm checking out all the walls, and I don't think they have any more of the ones left, so I might have to call up MacArthur and see if they have them, because it's looking pretty slim. I think I might have slept too long, and they actually sold out this time. I think I messed up. So no luck at Foot Locker, so the next spot I'm gonna hit is Commonwealth, see if they got any new stuff, any restocks, and then after that, I don't know, might have to call up another mall. I got my hand on the truck. Yeah. I got my hand on her puss. What? All in the nigga that puss. What? He want her way like a wuss. What? I got the paper like books. I can't pull up in some book. Walking that bitch in the bitches they look. All of these niggas they show. 29 hop in the tub. Watch my little boss and I make a look call. Yo. Nigga, fuck your squad, nigga, ASAP, bitch. Okay, so we just got done in Commonwealth, and your boy did walk away with a bag. So we got something at least today. I still need those ones, though. I still need to find the ones, though. Okay, so YouTube, listen. We are on the move right now. I called around, and there's one mall with one size left, and I should be able to make that one work. Now, I have 2 hours to get there, but like I said, there's only one shoe. There's one shoe left, and your boy needs to secure that joint, and it's a 20-minute drive, so... Listen, I'm gonna have to montage y'all up. Then we're gonna be at the next mall. The next mall, you're not supposed to record, but y'all already know I'm gonna get that footage for you. So we're gonna be right back. We might have to skip the thrift for today,
We just might have to.
Eventually.
What is good? We are back. We are at MacArthur Mall now. I need to keep my head on a swivel because last time I was here, a security guard walked up on me and told me not to record. So we're gonna have to keep our eye out for it. So we made it here in about a good 10, 15 minutes. I know Foot Locker is downstairs and I see a security guard right now. He is right behind me. He's in a white t-shirt. I'm gonna take this quick route downstairs because I know that his eyes are on me right now and we need to get these ones. So I'll be right back, all right? All right, y'all, so I called and they told me the last size they had was like 11 or 11 and a half, I don't remember. But this one right here is a 13. So y'all know how people do when you call. So anyways, they got the cool gray here too. I might slick wait until these go on sale, honestly. I like it, but I might have to wait until it's going on sale. I don't know if they're really moving like that, but these guys right here, definitely gotta make it work. Basically, I called and asked about these right here, and they actually gave me the size. There's only one size 11 in these bread 13. So right now, my only option is a 13. Other than that, everything else is gone. Damn it, I shouldn't have slept, bro. I was sleeping yesterday, bro. I should have been wide awake, but I was sleeping. We're gonna see, though. We're gonna see.
And of course, the last size they have is a 12, and they look weird right here. I don't know.
The quality is very high.
Yeah, I think it's good, but
half size big though.
Yeah, I don't know about it.
We came, we saw, and we did indeed get the last pair. We got the last size. So what I'm gonna do now is I think there's one more store in my area that's gonna be getting them and they don't have them yet. So we're gonna go back and we're gonna talk about them because I've seen a lot of people who are really, really iffy on this last release. Me personally, seeing them in hand and seeing them in the store, I actually like them. The knit looks kind of cool. Some people don't like the knit, some people just like the straight up leather. But I don't think it's a bad move for Nike to adapt some of their old models to the Flyknit version. I like Flyknit more than the Ultra, I guess you would say, depending on the shoe, like the Ultra 97s work. I don't know if a Flyknit 97 would work, but I mean, I'm pretty sure Nike's trying it out. But listen, we need to get back to the house. I'm gonna catch y'all though, peace.
All right, y'all, we are back at the crib, back in the studio, as you guys can see. I did have two brand new pickups today. So we're gonna start off with a small bag. This was just something I caught from Commonwealth. I'm not sure when they stock any more pleasure stuff. I just know that this was a tee that I was looking at on their IG for a while, and they had it actually in store in a couple different sizes. So I got this joint. This is the Pleasures body tee, and I'm just a fan of Pleasures, so you guys already know. I show off their stuff in a couple different videos here and there. One of those more smaller brands that I like that I really dig, and this is just a body tee. I really like the Pleasures font. I like the colors they use on this one, and you guys can kind of see a little bit closer up on the details of the actual t-shirt. I think it ran me about $35. Just a new t-shirt pickup from Pleasures. This is something that you guys are pretty used to seeing on my channel. So yeah, new tee, and let's get into the main thing, which is down here, of course, in this Foot Locker bag. Now, what I'm going to do is, because this is a size 13, I wanted to get them in hand, and I was thinking that maybe it might be possible for me to do at least an on-foot for you guys in these shoes. But the way they're made and the way Flyknit is, when you get a shoe with that knit material, you want it to be as best fitting, the perfect fit as possible. And I think for this shoe, going a half size down is gonna give you the best look on your toes, and I don't think it's gonna bunch up as much. Because one thing that I did notice that my homie did mention about this shoe is that when you put it on, the toe box just looks kind of wide. From right here, you probably really can't tell, but trust me, in hand, in person, when you put the shoe on, I definitely think you're gonna go at least a half size down. If you need to get your true size, grab your true size. And my thoughts and opinions is, it's not a bad shoe at all. I actually like the red little bit of knit behind here, and the leather on the inside as well, the leather on the swoosh is really good leather. I'm not really sure why people were hating on these so much. So here's a good close-up look at the actual Flyknit Air Jordan 1, and I honestly think it's pretty clean. It's definitely more lightweight, and they definitely do, especially when I put them on, they feel flat. They feel a little bit more flat than your regular Air Jordan 1, because although the Flyknit is comfortable, with this one, it makes the inside almost feel like one of those deconstructed ones. But I wouldn't be surprised if they start to move this Flyknit version or these Flyknit adaptations of old Jordan retros into the 2 or the 3. Now, I don't know what other model they could do that would look or work as good as the 1. I think that the 1 has a good shape to go with the Flyknit. I actually really like the tongue, how they have that detail there. The leather accents, I don't really know how they would do a Flyknit 8 or a Flyknit 3 or a Flyknit 4. I mean, I guess we'll just have to see in the future when they start dropping them, or they, you know, drop pictures, or if they ever do it. I mean, maybe they not do it. Maybe I'm just talking a whole bunch of bullshit and they never actually move forward with that. So listen, those are going to be my first thoughts and first opinions on the Flyknit Air Jordan 1. Listen, y'all chime in down below. Let me know how you're feeling about this shoe. But that is going to be it for this video. Much love to all the fam, followers, and of course supporters. You guys can follow me on Instagram, Twitter, SoundCloud, and Snapchat at bull.cb. By the way, here, there, blase blah, of course, Bullet RC. And your boy got extremely lucky one day after release, and trust me, I will be looking for that size 11.5 from one of the shops that haven't dropped them yet in my area. So just be looking for that one soon. I need to get out of here. Y'all be easy. Peace. Hey. 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 Spent 50K on the rollie. Just brought that shit and my bitch broke it. She saying that she need notice.